guys, DNC Productions here. Today I've got a bit of a different video for you guys because I was a teen mum. Today's a story time about how I found out I was pregnant at the age of 15. So, to get into it, basically came across this guy, as you do, took a liking to me, I took a liking to him. Now, you know, after speaking to him for a bit of time, I felt like, you know, this guy really liked me, you know, whatever else. You know, I was 15, I was naive, but anyways. So what had happened was, after talking to him for some time, did the deed, as you do, and he had told me that, you know what, let's even call out his name. His name, Earl. Earl had told me, basically, the night when we did the deed, that I should go and get the morning article the next day. Because basically he had, you know, we had a little accident. Anyway, next day, went to go and get the morning article. Now at that point, normally when they gave you the morning after pill, they would give you an appointment to come back to the clinic 3 weeks later to do a pregnancy test, just to make sure, either, you know, check that it worked or not, which whatever the case is. So I was given the pill that day. I had taken it, you know, I didn't really think nothing much about it, you know, whatever else. Took the pill. Obviously, only later on I found out the pill hadn't worked. Waited out the few weeks, the 3 weeks. Went back to my appointment at the clinic. It's funny because I remember this day like it was yesterday. I was in a clinic thinking to myself, you know, just thinking, you know, your mind is kind of tossing and turning between what about if I am, or if I'm not, you know, kind of thing. You know, while I was waiting in the waiting room. Then I got called in. I was given a little tub, you know, the containers they give you for you to do your urine sampling. Had done that, gave it back to the nurse. She had done a pregnancy test outside of the room that I was in. She came back in the room and she had said to me, basically, oh, congratulations, you're pregnant. So let's just remember again, I was 15 years old. Yeah. So obviously, the news of I'm pregnant at the age of 15 just literally flew over my head. Literally just flew over my head. When I had left, in all honesty, it didn't even feel like it was real, to be honest. It had felt like I was just woken up out of a dream. So I just carried on my day as normal. You know, it's so funny because even when I think about it now, my friends looking back have said to me that, you know, the day I found out I was pregnant, you know, I just casually came out with, oh yeah, by the way, I'm pregnant. But I don't think it really sank in, even though I was saying it out loud. So it got to the point, I think it must have been about a week after or so, you know, it kind of hit me that, okay, I'm pregnant. But it still didn't seem real. It was just thinking about the day I found out I was pregnant. And it kind of, you know, just dawned on me that I'm pregnant. So at that point, I'm not going to lie, I started to shit bricks. Obviously being 15, I'm at home with my mum, living at home with my mum. So the first thing I'm thinking to myself is, crap, okay, now that I've come to the understanding I'm pregnant, how do I go about telling my mum I'm pregnant and I'm 15? So I'm still in secondary school, you know, whatnot, about to do my GCSEs, my exams, and I just couldn't pluck up the courage to tell my mum that I was pregnant. I didn't know how, I didn't know what was going to happen. I thought once I told my mum was going to give me beats, I just didn't know. You know, I was thinking of so many different scenarios in my mind at that point of how it was going to happen once I told her, but I still couldn't pluck up the courage to go and tell her that I was pregnant. So, anyways, some weeks later, I was like, you know, after tossing and turning and thinking to myself, okay, I can't keep this a secret forever. At some point, I'm gonna start to show. At some point, I'm gonna have a bump. At some point, my mom's gonna notice something's going on. I had to tell her, I had to pluck up the courage and tell her, I'm pregnant. Anyway, one day, finally managed to get the courage, even though I was still nervous as hell, I'm telling you, boy, shaking, I'm telling you, literally. I said to my mum, I was at home that day, my mum told her, I said, there's something I wanted to talk to her about. Damn, when I tell you, listen, literally, shitting. I mean, I was so scared, I was so nervous, I felt so many emotions all in one, I'm telling you. So many emotions all in one. Anyways, I said, yeah, there was something I had to talk to her about. So we went to her room, sat down, still trying to pluck up the courage again to try and tell her what I'm about to tell her. Then after breathing or taking some deep breaths, then I plucked up the courage and I said to her, Mom, I'm pregnant. So at that point, my body just kind of went cold because I didn't even know. I just blurted it out. It was like there was no going back at this point now. So my mum had then said to me that she knew. Now, when I tell you the shock that I had from her saying to me she knew. So obviously my next question to her was like, what do you mean you know? How did you know? Like, no one, who told you? You know, was my first thought. She said to me, she knew. She had a gut feeling. I was like, wow. She said that she had known for a few weeks and she was waiting for me to come and tell her, to pluck up the courage to come and tell her. I can't believe, like, that just went over my head. I was like, wow. You know, I was shocked. I was taken aback. So, anyway, after that conversation with my mum, we went on to, obviously, her asking me questions. Who was the father, you know, la-di-la, whatever. I had told her, you know, how it all happened, whatnot. She had asked for his number because she wanted to call him and speak to him. I gave her his number. You know, my mum being concerned and obviously being worried about me, you know, whatnot. She wanted to speak to the guy and find out what was going on. So she called him. When she had called him, basically she told him, you know, that I'm pregnant, whatnot, you know, what was he gonna do. This guy at this point, I'm not gonna lie, was considerably somewhat older than me. So obviously him being at that age and me being 15, you know, she was asking him, you know, what are you gonna do? You know, you have responsibilities now, my daughter is pregnant with your child, kind of thing, you need to man up, you know, kind of conversation, you know, whatever else. At first, he wasn't really trying to hear it. He was kind of like, oh, you know, no, it's not mine. And kind of that thing that guys be like, how do I know it's mine? Now, I ain't gonna lie to you guys, it could have been nobody else's but his child, only for the simple fact that he was the guy who took my virginity, point blank. So it could only be his child. Obviously, once that conversation had been done, you know, my mum said to him, you know, you should come down, we should have a conversation, you know, figure stuff out, you know, moving forward. He said he was gonna come, but never showed up. Months passed by at this point. The carnival had come. So this is the month of August. So I live in the UK, and every August we have the carnival. It's a big thing, you know, in the UK that happens in London every year. I wasn't able to go, or didn't, not even I wasn't able to go, but I didn't want to go to the carnival at this point, you know, being I was pregnant like a good few months in to my pregnancy. I didn't really want to go be there, you know, like around crowd and a whole heap of people, so I decided to stay my ass at home. Anyways, my friends went to the carnival, and funnily enough, they bumped into him. you know, they were like, oh, questioning him, oh, you know, I'm at home, you know, pregnant with your child, how come I haven't been around yet, when are you going to go see her, you know, my friends were asking all these questions, you know, out of concern. He was saying, oh yeah, he's going to come around, see me, la la la, you know, whatever. Didn't happen. Again, sometime down the line, still into my pregnancy, he called me one day. This was the month before I was due to give birth to my daughter. Called me in the month of February and said to me, oh, you know, because I told him, you know, I was trying to keep him as updated as I possibly could by calling him, leaving a message on the phone, you know, when I found out she was a girl, you know, what my appointments were like, because he never turned up to any of my appointments. He never came, never showed any interest, you know, whatever else, whatnot. So, but you know, I did little things to kind of, you know, keep him kind of in the loop as much as possible, as much as I possibly could anyway, from my end. Letting him know she's a girl, blah, blah, when she was going to be due, you know, the month of March. So he called me a month before, so he called me in February, saying that he wanted to come see me, he wanted to come and, you know, support me, you know, be involved in his child's life, whatnot, whatever else. So I said, you know, that's fine, because that's all I wanted. Now, throughout the whole pregnancy, it was you weren't together, you know, at all. No relationship, you know, no communication apart from the odd one, two here, there, you know, whatever else. So my concern at that point was more for my child. You know, is the father of my child going to have take an active role in her life? That was my priority, that was my concern. So he had said he was going to come. He never turned up again. Got to the point that I had my daughter, gave birth to her. Beautiful little girl. And within the first few weeks of having her, you know, I was really emotional because, you know, I was just thinking that, why would you not want to come and meet your daughter? This daughter, this girl, she's so beautiful, like, you're missing out, basically. And I felt like she is missing out on having a father, and it hurt me a lot. You know, I remember really being emotional about it back then, to the point that I even started getting into poetry. You know, I was writing poetry in regards to my feelings, how I felt in regards to him, me wanting him to come and meet his daughter, be in his daughter's life, you know, type of things, whatnot. At some point, I will actually put a little snippet, I'll make a video and read out some of the poetry, if I can dig them out from somewhere and read them out to you guys and add them in this video. You know, I did a lot of poetry about, you know, wanting him to be around and involved in his daughter's life. That time never came, he never turned up, never heard from him again. So, as my daughter knows, she's never met her father till this day. Which is really sad, you know, because obviously a child deserves to have both mother and father in their life. And Earl, being the coward that he is, was and is, you know, never took that initiative to come and meet his daughter, be involved in his daughter's life, you know, whatnot. And it's quite sad, you know. It's sad for the child because the child misses out on having a father in her life. It's been quite some time, you know, for both of us. So my daughter's getting on with her life, I've got on with my life, you know, in regards to her. You know, my concern had only been for her. I kind of got over very quickly the fact that me and him were going to be in a relationship context, we were going to be a family, we were going to set up home, you know, pretty much after the point that I gave birth to my daughter and he never showed up and I never heard from him. And funny enough, we went to the area, we did go to the area, he was from Croydon, we went to the area, went to his house, looking for him, whether he was still living there or not, I don't know. Somebody else came to the door at that point, answered the door, and had said that that person of that name did not live there. And that was that, that was it, that was the end of that. Never spoken to him ever since then. not have had any contact with him ever since then. He hasn't tried to contact us or get in touch with us ever since then. And that's what it's been. And that, it was hard back then. It was really hard. It was really hard. It was hard really for my daughter's sake, because I really wanted her to have her father in her life. But yeah, that pretty much wraps up my story of my teen pregnancy. Being 15 and pregnant. My labour actually was, obviously it was my first pregnancy, so everything was kind of like, everything was new. I remember it happened at night, my water just broke. When my water was breaking, I freaked out. My mum came out of her room because I screamed. I said my waters are broken, we are called the ambulance. This kind of happened like around 9 p.m. Called the ambulance, they came, they took me to the hospital, which was quite local to us at that point. Took me to the hospital, got to hospital, I was just in pain, just crying, I was just begging for them to give me some. Give me some drugs, some to take the pain away. At that point, after checking me over, whatnot, the midwife came back in the room, she gave me some pethidine. Injected that right in my butt. Let me tell you, when that thing hit me, when that thing licked me, I slept, conked out for 3 hours straight. I could kind of feel the pain when I was sleeping, but hey, the thing made me feel like, oh, and I just slept pretty much throughout the whole labor. 3 hours was my labor, 3 hours and a bit, and some change. Then I woke up, I think it was probably like around 12, midnight. Felt like I wanted to go and poo, do a number two. Went first, I went to the toilet. My mum was with me. She was by my bedside in my room. Went to the toilet, nothing came out. Went back to bed, tried to sleep again. God, I felt this urge to poo again. Went to the toilet again. Nothing came out. At this point, my mum was like, you've been to the toilet twice, ain't nothing come out. I think the baby's trying to come. So, my mum went and called the midwife. At this point, I felt like the urge to push. The midwife had come in. She had said, okay, it's time to take you up to where the room, the delivery suite, to deliver your baby. So I went to the delivery suite. At this point now, you know, she's obviously talking me through it because, like I said, it's my first pregnancy. It's all new to me. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know. All I know is I'm in pain. You know, I'm getting these pain. I'm contracting on my back. Like, the pain is so bad. You know, I'm just like, ah, you know, that kind of thing, whatever. And she's telling me, obviously, instead of me, you know, she's trying to talk me into just like bearing down and pushing. So obviously I'm trying to bed, I should send me to bed, and with every contraction that I get, I should just push. So after some pushes, you know, whatever, she had, which I'll make sure you guys a picture also, when I read out the poetry for you guys, she had basically, after some pushes, she was crowning. Now, I didn't know what this burning sensation was that I was getting when her head was crowning at all. But the midwife said to me, that's normal, that's when her head is crowning. Next thing I knew, she was out. The midwife told me, literally, she flew out, boy, like Superman. I'm telling you, no lie. But yeah, she was out. She was born. I was emotional. I couldn't believe it. I was a mom for the first time. I cried. I held her. She was so tired. I held her so close, you know, and just it. I was just full of so much love for her. And I just knew that from here on out, she was my world, she is my life. I was gonna love her, protect her, look after her, take care of her, provide her, be there for her every step of the way in her life. Do you know what I mean? In the day, be there for her through the goods and through the bads. Do you know what I mean? In the day, I just knew that this was it. I was her mum, but I couldn't believe it. So that was my neighbour. Then I brought her home after a few days of being in hospital for a few days. My blood pressure kind of played up at that point, so I had to stay at home for a few days. I mean, in hospital for a few days. Then went home, took her home. And from then on, like, we lived our lives, you know, together, with having a lot of support from my mum and whatnot. And that's my story of how I was a teen mum, my pregnancy, absentee father, my labour, delivering my daughter, and how it all went down. If you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to give us a big thumbs up, subscribe, and drop me a comment down below for what your experience might have been like if you were a teen mum. For me, I don't regret the fact that the morning of school didn't work. I'm actually happy it didn't work, but that's not me condoning any young teenager going out and getting pregnant at a young age. No. But it's just for me, personally speaking, I'm happy it didn't. I felt truly blessed to have my daughter. I still feel blessed to have my daughter. And for me, I won't change it. If I could go back and do it again, I would do it all the same. Aside from the fact that her father wasn't involved in her life, that would be the only thing that I would change. But aside from that, that's my story time. I'm out. This is enough, Shells!